Welcome to the induction video for computer science at the Sixth Form College. Normally, obviously, you'd be coming to a meeting and you'd be doing all sorts of things in class. What I'm going to do now is briefly talk a little bit about the course, but mainly do the kind of activity that we do during induction. So firstly, if you want to know about what's on the course, it's all on the website. A-level computer science involves studying the theory behind how computers work, but mainly and most importantly, programming. We use JavaScript and learning to solve problems using programming. That's the key thing. So if you want to look at the detail of what goes on the course, then you can look on the website. You can see that there. What we're going to do now is do some programming that we would do in the induction normally. First thing we want to do is we want to go to a site called Open Processing. So let's find Open Processing, and you can follow along and pause whenever you need to. We are going to sign in. So you will have an account, so let's join. Okay. I am Roger. My email is rogercomputing@gmail.com. I am not a robot. I need to prove I'm not a robot. Okay, so Open Processing is a library that allows us to use really nice graphic routines in JavaScript. It's an online community and we create sketches. When you create a sketch, the first thing that happens is it makes this default code, and there's a setup function. The setup function happens once when the program runs, and there's a draw function, and the draw function happens every time the page gets drawn, every render frame. So that's about 30 or 50 times a second. At the moment, it looks like this. Whenever, wherever I move the mouse, a circle gets drawn, because on draw, an ellipse that is 20 by 20, so the same height and the same width, is drawn as mouse X, mouse Y, and that's exactly where the mouse is. And we're going to turn this into a bouncing ball and then turn it into something a little bit better later on. So let us make a start. You can copy along and pause as you need to. First off, I'm going to need a ball and I want it to be in a particular location. So I need to declare some variables. So I shall have X and I shall make that equal to 0, and I shall have Y and make that equal to 0, and I shall have a velocity for that ball. And when I draw, all I'm going to do is I'm going to draw the ball at x, y, but I'm also going to add on the velocity. So I'm going to change x, I'm going to make it equal to x plus vx, and y is going to be equal to y plus vy. So now when I run this, there goes the ball. It's gone straight off the bottom of the screen, but that's fine. That's exactly what we told you to do. Every frame, X and Y have increased by 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, and it's gone all the way down the screen. Now what I want to do is see if it bounces off the side of the walls. So let's start with things that went off the bottom of the screen. Let's start with that. We want to see if the Y, if that is greater than the height of the screen. So if Y is greater than the height of the screen, and indeed if it's going to bounce less than the top of the screen, so if it is less than the, or in JavaScript it's that bar sign, we need two of those. There'll be somewhere on the keyboard, typically down the bottom left, but you can find it. If y is less than zero, if this is the case, then I want it to reverse. So I want the y velocity to be opposite to what it was before. So vy is going to equal negative vy. So if y is greater than the height, or y is less than zero, change the velocity to be go backwards, basically. Now let's have a look at this. Down comes the ball, hits the bottom, and then goes up off the top. Now, it's still bouncing off the top. We can't see it because we haven't done the X. So let's do the X. Similar thing. If X is greater than the width, in this case, of the screen, or X is less than zero, then we want to change that X velocity and make it equal to negative VX and close that bracket. So now when I run this, this happens. And that is going to stay contained within that screen. And it'll keep on doing that for quite some time, actually. If I just talk for a little while whilst it bounces about, you see it's nice and regular. It's always moving by 10 in the X direction and 10 in the Y direction. And it's overlaying itself as it goes along. Now what we're going to do next is add some randomness to this, some colour and some to the shape. So let's have a look. The first thing I want to do is the colour. I'm going to make it so that every time it gets drawn, it chooses a random colour. Let's just make this a little bit bigger for you. Let's hope that's okay. It's probably a bit big, that's better. So we're going to fill the ellipse in a random colour. I'm going to choose random. Now, hopefully, many of you have heard of red, green, blue, not just the colours, but RGB is a colour system. I'm going to have a random amount of red, a random amount of green, and a random amount of blue. Now when I run this, every time the ball gets drawn, a new random colour is chosen. I've still got this black line around the ellipse, so I'm going to get rid of that. In computer graphics, we have two things that we use for colour. One is the fill colour, and one is the stroke colour. Think of the stroke as being the pencil you draw the outline with, and fill being the paint that you fill it in with. So I'm just going to get rid of that outline. So up here I'm going to say there's no stroke. And you see that makes quite a big difference because it doesn't have the outline. It makes the whole, makes the ball look much smoother, really, much softer. It's not harsh because it's going to have that harsh outline done in black. So we could have changed it to a different colour if we wanted, but I think that's fine for that. Now we're going to change the size of it. At the moment, the ellipse is always 20 by 20. I'm going to make it a random size. I want it to be, I don't want it to be too small. Let's have it between 5 and 50. Now that's the width. I'm going to do the same thing, random 550, for the height as well. So every time it draws in a random colour and a random size. So that's going to look quite different. So you can see sometimes it's wide and not very tall. Sometimes it's quite round. Sometimes it's small and round or big and round. And sometimes it's narrow but tall. So you know, it can be obviously random sizes, but it's still doing the regular pattern. It's still bouncing, still moving 10 by 10. So let's change that now. Here we've got the VX and the VY, they're the velocities. I don't want just to make them random numbers because that would jump it about all over the place. I want to change them by a little bit. So I'm going to make the VX, the X velocity, I'm going to make it equal to the VX plus a small random amount. So VX equals VX plus random, something between minus 0.05 and plus 0.05. And we do the same for the Y. So we're changing the X velocity and the Y velocity just by a little bit, a small negative bit, a small positive bit, somewhere in between those two things. Let's have a look and see what happens. Okay, so it's still pretty straight, really. That's not enough. It's beginning to, you see that the lines are no longer as parallel as they were. But it still isn't very random, so let's change that. Let's make these half and half. Now let's see what happens there. There we go, there's quite a lot of variation. Still going fairly straight, but it's oh, there we go, beginning to vary about. Okay, so we've got something that's bouncing about all over the place. We've got it making sure that it is different colors. Oh, didn't even get to the edge there. And it's doing a random shape and a random color. So yeah, that's quite a nice place to be. But there's a very significant thing that we want to do next, and that'll take us about another 5 minutes. So let's do that. We're going to have quite a lot to change. So what we're going to want to have is multiple balls. At the moment, we've just got one. We're going to have many. And to do this, we're going to take the code we've got. We're going to copy it into a new thing called a class. We're going to have a class called ball, and it has a constructor, and in that constructor we store its x position and we store its y position and we store its x velocity. We'll make that a random number to start off with between minus 10 and 10. Make the y velocity a random number between minus 10 and 10 as well. Let's give ourselves some space. And we'll give things a color as well. So I shall have color. I think I'll use the same thing I did before. Here's my randomness. So what I have is a ball class. Every time a ball gets made, this constructor code here is going to run. It's going to store whatever x value we give it and whatever y value we give it. It's going to create a random x and y velocity and a random color. Now, when I draw that ball, what I want to happen is pretty much exactly the same stuff that we had before. I want the x and the y to change. I want the velocity to change a little bit, and I want all of the conditions of bouncing off the sides to be kept. So I'm going to copy this from here and I'm going to pop it down here. But I've got to change each of these to be this dot vx rather than just a vx. So vy becomes this dot vy, x becomes this dot x, vx, this dot y, this dot vy, this dot y, this dot y. Because what we're doing here is we're going to create a whole bunch of balls. Each of them is going to have their own velocity and their own position. So when I draw, I change the velocity. I modify the position by the velocity. I check whether that is still on the screen or not. And then finally, I'm going to draw it. So we'll have the ellipse. Copy that. Let's draw an ellipse at this dot x. Oops. This dot. But it's not going to be a random size anymore. Oh, so it's, we'll keep the random size. There we go. And there's one thing we're missing. We need to set the fill to be this dot color. Okay, so that finishes that. That finishes that. So we've got those extra little brackets at the end. Now, that was quite a lot of stuff. Hopefully, obviously you can pause as you've been going along. If we get this, now what I want to do is say there's going to be a ball. So let's have balls equals a nice empty list. On the setup, I'm going to add Newball at the middle of the screen, which is width divided by 2 and height divided by 2. And then when we draw, I'm going to draw the balls. So draw a B of balls. B dot draw. What is happening here is I've got a list here. At the moment, it has nothing in. On setup, we push a new ball into that balls list. And then when we draw the thing. And the draw code will be this draw code. So when I run it, I should have one ball. There we go. Now, because it's not changing colour anymore, but it's just a random colour, every time I start it, it's a different colour. I get quite an interesting thing there, but I'm going to have it looking more like a ball just by doing one thing. I'm also going to have this background line. I'm going to move it from there. I'm going to put it here. And that will make this happen. So that's almost exactly the same code, but it's clearing the screen first. And now, one more thing to do. The last thing I'm going to do is I'm going to use the mouse dragged function. And on mouse drags, I'm going to create a new ball, but I'm going to create it where the mouse is. So when I drag the mouse, I'm going to create a new ball at the mouse X and the mouse Y position and push that into the balls list. And now this is what happens. And that is what we do on computer science. Thanks for watching.